Welcome to the dynamics tutorials. So with this problem, we have a particle that's following a curved path. So this is called curvilinear motion. We're going along a curved line in the plane. And we have this information that the curve y is equal to 2 times the square root of x. And we have information that the x component of the velocity is 0.5 times t squared, where velocity in x is in meters per second when t is in seconds. And then we have these initial conditions that x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0 at t is equal to 0. So let's go through and solve this one. Let's start off with dx dt is equal to vx. So we have our expression for vx, so we can plug this down into here. We need to now separate variables, so we have our x's on one side and our t on the other side, so we'll multiply through by dt. Then we get dx is equal to 0.5 t squared dt. Now we can integrate this. So this is going to go from x is equal to 0 here, when t is equal to 0, up to x is equal to x and t is equal to t. We want to maintain a function after we integrate, so we don't want to run this up to any particular numerical value. We want it to run up to a variable here, and we want this to run up to the variable t here. So integrating this, we wind up with the 0.5 t squared, so this will become t cubed divided by 3. So 0.5 will be divided by 3 and give us the 0.1667 times the t cubed. We'll plug in the limits here, so we get x is equal to x minus x is equal to 0. We're subtracting off 0, so nothing on this side. And then we'll plug in the limits, t is equal to t minus, and then we'll plug in 0 for t. And so again, nothing to subtract off. But always make sure that you go back and look at your limits and plug your limits in. Then we can get our value for x when t is equal to 1 second and get our 0.167 meters, and then we can plug this value for x back in our function here. So in place of the square root x, we'll have square root 0.167, and then we'll get our value for y. Y is equal to 2 times the square root of 0.167, and we get 0.817 meters. Now we can look back at our equation for y. So y is equal to 2 square root of x. Now let's plug this whole function back in here. So when we get that and then finish up the algebra, we get that y is equal to 0.8167 t to the 3 halves. Then we can go back and take a derivative of that y with respect to t. And so when we do that, we'll get 3 halves multiplied by this coefficient, so 1.225, and then t to the 1 half. We can now plug in t is equal to 1 second, we get a vy is 1.22 meters per second. And for our vx, we already have the function, so we just plug in t is equal to 1 second and get vx is equal to 0.5 meters per second. And then now we can calculate our acceleration. So with our acceleration, that'll be the time derivative of our velocity function. So here's our velocity function, so we'll have a 1 half times its coefficient, so 0.6125 times t to the negative 1 half. Again, plug in t is equal to 1 second and we get our acceleration in the y. And then for acceleration in x, it's just going to be the time derivative of our velocity in the x. Going back up to here, so it's going to be 2 times 0.5 times t raised to the first power. Plug in t is equal to 1 second and we get our ax is 1 meter per second squared. Thanks for watching.